In SwiftUI, it's often advisable to avoid using spacer unnecessarily. While spacer can be a handy tool for creating flexible layouts, overusing it can lead to unexpected spacing issues and make your code harder to maintain. Instead, use frame. This approach not only makes your code more readable, but also ensures better control over the placement and distribution of views in your SwiftUI interfaces, promoting a more organized and maintainable code base. Yes, spacer is used everywhere in SwiftUI, but today I'm going to show you a better way of aligning your views. We're going to go through how to use spacer and what's it good for, and then what are the disadvantages, and then I'm going to show you what to do instead. So I have set up here a vanilla Xcode project. Now, if we build and run this in the simulator, you will see that we have the globe and the hello world text. This is centered. That's how these texts, that's how containers work. They are centered. So what are spacers? Well, with spacers, you can just space, you can just push out, well, push to somewhere all of the other views. You see, it's just pushed up. Now, why is this happening? You have to understand why is this layout the way it is. And for that, you need to understand a concept about layouts in SwiftUI. And that is, there are basically two types of views in SwiftUI. One is a push-out view that is trying to push everything away from itself. It's trying to take up as much space as it can. And the other type of view is a pull-in view. It's trying to pull every other view around itself to itself. It's trying to stay as small as possible. Now, as you can see, hello world, the text, and also the image, the system named image, is a pull-in view. It's trying to pull everything around itself. And also, the spacer is a push-out view. It's trying to take up as much space as it can. The same goes for a color. Let's just have a color right over here so you may better understand how these push-out views work. So the color is taking up as much space as it can. And also, as you can see, there's also a padding, so as much space as it can. So that's our one use of a spacer. As you can see, also the color is doing the same thing because it has the same properties. It's a push out view. But what if we are using a spacer with a color? So for that, I'm going to remove the padding. Let's build and run again so we can see what's going on right over here. And I'm going to add just a spacer right over here. And let's just remove this vertical stack into a horizontal stack. So let's change that. Now, as you can see, the spacer now behaves a little bit oddly because, okay, these are two push-out views, but the color is kind of has a priority, a better, a higher priority than the spacer. And yeah, it does. So you need to know that the spacer indeed is a push-out view, but when added to other push-out views, it will adjust accordingly. So it will squeeze itself to whatever space it, you know, the other push-out view needs. And the color red, in this case, it needs all of the space. Now there's also, you can see this white line, that's the spacer. In some cases, we don't want that. So there's another initializer for the spacer, and that is with the minimum length. So with the minimum length, let's just add in here 30 maybe. That would be the minimum length of the spacer that would be pushed up onto from another push-out view. In this case is 30. Some cases you just want to, the color red in this case, or a text or whatever, to take up as much space as it can. Therefore, we are abandoning the default value that the spacer has for the minimum length and setting it to zero. Now, the color red is taking up all of the space if it needs to or if it wants to. Of course, this is optional, so if you just set it to nil, then the default value will be used, or just remove the minimum length property and then the default value will be used, which is a nil. And this number is kind of a magic number from Apple. It just looks great on all devices. At rebeloper.com/mentoring, I offer an exceptional mentoring session tailored specifically to SwiftUI enthusiasts. Whether you're a beginner looking to grasp the fundamentals or an experienced developer aiming to master advanced techniques, I will provide personalized support, hands-on training, and practical insight to help you unlock the full potential of SwiftUI. Join my mentoring program today and embark on a transformative journey towards becoming a proficient SwiftUI developer. The link is down in the description. Now, there's another use case for the spacer. That is if we add a spacer after our color, and that will just squeeze it between. And most probably you know this, it's just setting things in center. But this is so cumbersome, you know, you have to add a new view right over here, you had to change this to the horizontal stack. So let's hit Command Z all the way back, so we might have our initial hello world with the globe. And this time around, we are going to take this further. I'm going to show you why, well, what to do instead of spacer, because you know, spacer is fine, but there are much better ways of aligning our views to wherever we want to. And let me just remove the padding because we don't actually need that. And what I'm going to add in here is a frame. Now, that is really strange. Usually don't like frames. Well, I do like frames, but not with custom, like set values, like constant values with the width and height. Some cases that's okay, but it really, you need to be aware how it messes around with the layout of your SwiftUI view. But we're not going to use width and height. We are going to use max height right over here, max height, there we go. And we're going to go with infinity. And with the frame of max height, we have also the option of alignment right over here to be initialized with the alignment. And then we can just choose, let's just go with the top. Let's hit Command R. And now we see we have the same result, but our view is not cluttered with that spacer. We just had a view modifier, which is really, really amazing. Now, what if we wanted this? Well, of course, if you just moved it with alignment at the bottom, it will be on the bottom. I'm not going to add that. But what if we wanted to move all of this to the leading part? Well, with spacers, you would just need to have a horizontal stack and then just add a spacer over there. But with our frame, we just say max width. And again, use the value of infinity. And then for the alignment, we are going to say it's leading. And we are going to be put right over here. Our V-stack is going to put right over here. And please note that we did not actually change our V-stack into a horizontal stack. So if we wanted actually a V-stack, which we do, we wouldn't need to nest all of it inside the horizontal stack, which again makes our code much more complicated with the pyramid of doom and so forth. So this is really, really amazing. Now, it might be cumbersome to just know, okay, now we are in max width or max height, what should we do? Therefore, let's just create a simple extension for this. So let's have an extension of a view right over here. I'm going to create a function alignment. And that will take an alignment, actually. And what type of alignment? Well, we need a top, bottom, leading, and trailing. So the default alignment has a lot more. Therefore, I'm going to create an alignment. So let's create a frame alignment. Let's just call it frame alignment. There we go. And we will have four cases. Top, bottom, leading, and trailing. Okay, so this would be of type frame alignment. Okay, it will just give us back some view. There we go. Okay, so we just want to switch through that alignment. Switch alignment, and I'm going to use Xcode completion, which is really, really handy over here. And we're going to say self dot, well, let me just copy this out and adjust it accordingly. So if we are on top, we want to have a max height and infinity, and right over here it will be top. I'm going to hit Command D on this line to duplicate it, and Option Command closing brackets to move it down. And the alignment should be a bottom. Again, let's duplicate this and move it down and make the necessary changes. In this case, it would need to have max width, and the alignment would be leading, of course. Command D, Shift Command, closing brackets, and trailing is the alignment in this case. Now you will see that we are going to have one warning and one error and four of these warnings. Basically what this means is that we are trying to return some view, but we are returning four types of views right over here. Also, we are not actually returning because we did not add the return keyword before all of these four. So to make it really, really fixable, really simple, you just add the at view builder at in front of your function. That will mean that this is going to build our views, therefore it might expect different types, and the view builder takes care of it all. So now, instead of frame max width, we could just say dot alignment dot, let's just go for leading now, so we can see that's actually working. There we go, we have the leading, and by the way, this is much more wordy, so it's a much more as a natural language. Let's just go for top, maybe alignment top. There we go, we have that. Of course, let's just add also center. Maybe in some cases you just want to set it as center, so let's add a case of center. Let's duplicate this. Oh, there we go, duplicate, moving it down, and let's have this as center. By the way, the default alignment is center, so let's just select center also. Center, there we go, and it is centered. Of course, you will rarely use this. You are going to go top, bottom, leading, trailing in most cases. And that's how you replace the spacer. Now, this is one really good one-liner that you can use in your SwiftUI project. Check out another 10 one-liners that I'm really, really fond of. Check out the video, it's right over here.